Coffee, this juice that moves the world and captivates humanity with its vast influence. More than 100,000 tons of this substance are consumed every year worldwide, equivalent to the weight of the Eiffel Tower 20 times over. This precious stimulant primarily finds its home in cups of coffee and tea, but it also finds its way into some fizzy drinks, chocolate bars, and caffeine tablets. Coffee gives us a feeling of alertness, focus, happiness, and vitality, even when our body wants to rest. But beware, it may increase anxiety and blood pressure. It's the most consumed drug in the world. So, how does it kill us? Caffeine is extracted from plants to serve certain purposes and is found in high proportions in certain plant leaves and seeds. It's poisonous to insects, but when consumed in lower ratios, as in the case of nectar, it helps them remember the flowers and return to them. In the human body, caffeine acts as a stimulant for the central nervous system. They keep spending by preventing one of the key molecules responsible for sleep, an element called adenosine. The body needs regular energy supplies and gets it by breaking down a high-energy molecule called adenosine triphosphate. During this process, adenosine, the chemical basis for three adenosine prescriptions, is released. The nerves in the brain have receivers that are completely associated with this molecule. When adenosine reaches these receptors, it activates a series of biochemical reactions that slow down nerve efficacy and slow down the release of particles important for brain signals. In other words, it puts you to sleep. Caffeine is what is called an adenosine receptor antagonist. This means it disrupts the process of slowing down nerve cells by preventing the reception of adenosine. Caffeine and adenosine have a similar molecular structure. It's almost enough for caffeine to sneak into adenosine receptors, but not enough to activate them. In short, adenosine hampers nerve cells, and caffeine hinders that hindrance, so it acts as a stimulant for you. Caffeine can also elevate positive feelings. For some nerve cells, adenosine receptors are connected to receptors of another molecule called dopamine. One of its roles in the brain is to enhance feelings of pleasure. When adenosine reaches one of the paired receptors, it makes it difficult for dopamine to fit into its place, interrupting mood enhancement process. But when caffeine takes the place of adenosine, it doesn't have the same effect. The toadstool is in harmony with its place. There is evidence that the effects of caffeine on adenosine and dopamine receptors have long-term benefits. It reduces the risk of diseases like paralysis and dementia, and some types of cancer. Caffeine can also increase the body's ability to burn fat. In fact, some sports organizations believe that caffeine gives athletes an unfair advantage and have imposed restrictions on its consumption. From 1972 to 2004, Olympic athletes had to stay under a certain level of caffeine in the blood for their release. Competition. And of course, not all effects of caffeine are very beneficial. It may make you feel better and more spent, but it can increase the heart rate and blood pressure, causing an increase in the urination rate or diarrhea, and contributes to insomnia and anxiety. In addition, foods and drinks containing caffeine have their own effects on the body, which should be taken into account. The brain can adapt to regular caffeine consumption. If your adenosine receptors are constantly blocked, your body will make additional receptors. In this way, even with the presence of caffeine, adenosine can still perform its task for brain signals for sleep. For this reason, you might find yourself needing to consume more and more caffeine to feel alert. There are numerous adenosine receptors to control. And for this reason also, if you suddenly quit caffeine, you might experience unpleasant withdrawal symptoms. With many adenosine receptors and no competition, adenosine can work for a longer period, causing symptoms like headaches, fatigue, and feeling depressed. But within a few days, the extra adenosine receptors disappear, and your body will return to its normal, and you will feel awake just as you always feel, even without the most popular stimulant in the world.